Legend of Total War here with part 85 of my Mounted Blade Warband Anno Domini 1257 Let's Play campaign as Legend of Conqueror. So we're pushing into the final Sicilian territory here in Sicily at Palermo. We got a peace treaty with the Imperium Romani, so they got the better of us in that war, but it was best we just call the peace treaty. Just so we can handle with these other guys first, because we just don't have the, logistically, we just can't deal with them just yet. Tommaso, it's a different Tommaso. Oh, hang on, we should deal with this Tommaso, tomato, whatever, dude. Just capture him. What does he feel about me? Let's defeat him. So we got 885, just auto-resolve it, be fine. He managed to escape, though. I don't want to... I'm sick of constantly scrounging around for coins. I'd probably just get it from cash. Alright, so we come to Palermo, and let's see what they've got here. So, Lord Iaz is here. So they've got about 600 men, but we know we've got 800. It's not the best of situations, but let's besiege it. Requires ladders, okay. Worst case scenario is we don't win, but I'll come back. Okay, what's this? I've returned from a mission to the Imperium Romanum. Okay. Yeah, we already got peace with them. They offered it. And we're getting some more reinforcements. Good, so Palermo should be taken. We should be able to take this. And that'll just be the end of Sicily. They'll go to being what Poland is now. Just really just a nuisance. Not an actual threat. And then I'm thinking we're going to go deal with Navarre, because they just go from city to city conquering my least defended settlements. It's time to put them down, because I don't think their army will be very large, so we should be able to defeat them quite easily. Guys, I need to get through here. Excuse me. Oh wait, shit. There's a door in the way here. Oh, we haven't afforded a settlement type like this in a while. Help my guys up. Actually, probably one of the best ways I can help them is get rid of these archers. How are we going so far? Not well, but that's okay. We can turn it around. Fuck off. There we go. Stupid. Don't just sit there with a fucking shield. Just open your throat for me. Alright, good. That's a lot of their archer support dealt with. We're not quite there yet. Jeez, it took them that long to deal with them. While you're shooting them, or while you're bashing through that, I'll shoot these guys. They're probably coming from our rear any second now. And I can get him. Fuck them. Alright, smash them up. So, where are their reinforcements coming from? They're not coming from over this way, they're coming from down there. No, here they come. Battle should be going a bit better now that we've breached that tower. A decent kill zone here, not the best. So we've already killed 140 of them. That's a good start. And how many have we lost? Less than 100. Nope. This could be a good kill zone right here. This appears to be basically the end of Sicily. Without this settlement here, none of their armies that we've defeated will be able to recover any troops. They have nowhere to gain troops from, unless they can hire mercenaries somewhere. But even then, they're not going to have much cash. And all of their lords will desert him. Oh, taking a lot of damage. One thing about the Sicilians is it seems like their forces do tend to hit me quite hard whenever they do. Alright, that's 200 of them dead. I'm gonna try and break through this. Probably not the smartest of ideas, but if I can hit them in the rear, that's always preferable. Fuck that bloody shield bash. Go around me, bitch. Damn, these fucking narrow corridors, I'm out of here. Shit. Okay, good. Out of that. I'll just deal with the enemy reinforcements here. I like to be out in the open. Need space to move this thing around. It's too big. I can always just shoot them in the back. That's good. From this spot here, I can see when their reinforcements are showing up. Okay, we're almost halfway through killing them. And we've got plenty of reinforcements. It's nearly a 2-to-1 kill ratio at the moment. No, can't do anything about that now. They'll have to cut through that. Always feel good when I kill a javelin man without them hitting me. I always feel bad when they do get me. Okay, let's see if I can give it an auxiliary soldier. Good. Oh, javelin. Great. Come on, yeah. Okay, good. I don't have any good shots there. I'm not going to shoot into the back of my troops. But that's okay. Even if I do nothing now, we've won the fight. I mean, look at my guys go. They're absolutely slaughtering them. Good, that's just about 300 there. That's half of them. Still don't have a good shot, but they seem to be pushing us back a little bit. Soon I'll be able to shoot at them with the javelins. I mean, they've only got 5, so it's better than nothing. Oops, I think. Can't get in there just yet. I can't find reinforcements. Alright, let's see if I can get shot in there now. Get out of my way. Fucking idiot, you walked right into that. Luckily I didn't do much damage. Press the attack. Get through. I can't believe they're not bothering to attack me. They didn't even shield bash me. Except for that guy. Ah, this guy's a weakling anyway. Yeah, there's a scythe here. One hit dead. Well, well, I'm stuck here. I'll have to just wait my turn. Okay, 350 of them dead. About 200 remaining. 220 or something. I'm just glad to get rid of the Sicilians. I've been eyeing their lands for quite some time. Good, that's it. Push forward. Let's get out into the open where I can fight properly so these fucking narrow corridors. I see. They've got a lot of units that are stuck. That's where each wave is becoming less and less dangerous. I'm up on the front lines now, but probably end up getting killed. This soldier is good. You shield back a few times, but it's not a very strong move when I use it in this situation. Ah, damn it. Just... Oh well. Try and stay here with the small amount of health that I've got left. Just thin them out. Not really killing them, but dishing out damage will make it easier for my guys to fight. Well, this soldier certainly did his worth. That's great. Ah, there he goes. Four hundred of them dead. 150 remaining. We have to wait a while before we can get into this. So keep pushing. Oh, if we could jump through there, that would be great. I'm gonna give me a leg up. I can't get up there. I'm still even trying though. Back of the line again. Reinforcements aren't on their way. And we can't lose our position here. We've got to keep pushing forward. Come on. There's only a few of them left in that line there. Get them out and move. That's it. Yes, we're in the position that we need. Hit right here. Good if we could push forward just that little bit more. That's it. Come on, just a few of them left and then we can push further. Good. Alright, now we've got them. They've only got a handful of men left anyway. Less than 100, I think. because this battle is a little bit glitched, we may have to withdraw, depending on whether or not I keep getting auxiliary soldiers. If I can't get auxiliary soldiers, then we'll have to withdraw, because I can't tell them to walk through that invisible barrier there. Actually creamed these guys in this battle. But unfortunately, there are a lot to deal with still. Genax cuts through these doors pretty well. Okay, it would really help if I had like a crossbowman or something for this part, but whatever. If this soldier ends up getting killed without doing anything, no big deal. At least we've got the door down. Took me a while to bloody figure this out. To come up this way. All I can do is jump down. Maybe not focus too much on them, but on the archers if we can get to them. Shit. Keeps hitting me. Got him. Not bad at all. If he gets knocked out now, I'm really happy with what I did here. Hit whoever I can in the face. There I go. Oh crap, we're gonna have to get them to follow me. Got some silly guy with a feathered hat and a crappy spear. Hold the position there. They won't oh, come on, guys. I told you to hold that position. War cleaver, give me that. There you go. Gotta be just the upper strike. Downward strike, technically. Ah, oh, fuck. That did a lot of damage. Okay, so... Oh, fuck, it's time to charge. Only 33 of them remaining. I'd rather not withdraw, because this battle went quite well. So I've lost about 300 men to their 500. Not bad at all. Fucking archers. Or javelin men, or whoever it was that shot me there. It's this guy, wasn't it? Shit. Don't know how much health left. Archie's aiming for me. Gotta get rid of him quick. Gotta get rid of him. The soldier's not particularly strong. Shield bash outranges me for some reason. Another one bites the dust. Fucking javelin men. Well, I think that's it for auxiliary soldiers. Yeah, we'll have to withdraw. I can't get my guys to go through there. Call a meeting with him. Surrender. Fine. Yield to me. He's indifferent. Because this is the end of them, I will let them go. Let him go. So that maybe one day he'll become devoted to me and join me. Anyway, good way to gain on. Because they'll never ransom him back. That is essentially the end of Sicily. Because now the thing is, he's got no settlements to go back to replenish anyway, so he might as well just be thrown to the ether in a way. Okay, so Palermo is under our control. Marketplace, goods. Oh, I got all this stuff I can sell. And I'll take all this damn food. Still receive money. Because I don't have enough. That'll do. Okay, so the Sicilians have been dealt with. They're doomed. Now we have to keep moving. We have to head over here to defeat them. We should start here. That way we can fight both of them at the same time, hopefully. Or maybe I should come up here and deal with the English. We've got a significant sized force here. Should be okay. Oh, come on. How can the morale be low? We just defeated an entire faction. Custodes. God damn it. Who cares? At least they can't come back with any settlements, I think. I don't need any prisoners. We're okay for money for the time being. Okay, well, the war with Sicily went well. They didn't take any settlements, and we took all of those from them. However, gotta get up here and fight back. We can't just let this whole area fall to them. Hey, where are my guys? They must be fighting something else. What are they doing? They're fighting a bunch of bloody pirates or whatever. I need to prioritize a little bit more. These lands are already shit, don't worry about them. Removed from the treasury, yeah, probably due to raiding, but that's okay. Unwilling to conclude peace? Well then, no choice but to go kill him then. Lost Wexford, that's okay. Not focused too much on the English now. We need to undo the damage done by these guys now. Lost Minsk, whatever. Yep, that's okay. Now we're losing a lot of settlements here. But that's okay, it's all about taking away, or being at war with less people. And now we don't have to worry about Sicily. So now let's go fight the Navarrese. If we can fight their army and defeat them, then we can stop them from taking settlements and the rest of their regions will be ours for the taking. I really wish they wouldn't do that. Now, if I didn't tell you to go do it, don't go fucking do it. I need you guys to be at full strength to do with what we've got to do out here. We bloody help them take Tarnovo, pricks. Actually, if I come and help them there, since that's a French force, maybe the French will like me a little bit more. Yeah, it doesn't matter. We really can't afford to have the French go to war with us. That would be a game changer. But they're busy with their own shit. This isn't a huge force. It's maybe 1,000 men tops. Alright, let's do this. Let them raid. Raiding's no big concern. Ah, siege tower. God damn it. That just takes time, and we'll have some deserted men deserting us in the meantime as well. That's okay. It's time to bloody punish these guys. 24 hours is not that long for a siege. And it does give my guys a bit more time to get here and help us out. Alright, let's see what the battle advantage is. I'm hoping for 4. Five. Okay, well, oh god, I hate this settlement. That doesn't matter. Let's just take it and be done with it. Should have let the French finish you fuckers off. this settlement. But at least we've got a good battle advantage, so... Well, we must have at least 1,000 men. I would like it if we didn't lose half of them, though. Just fighting this, because I think we need to find the Navarrese army, because they are conquering too quickly for my liking. And we need to, you know, seriously put them down. Stop them from being able to conquer any more settlements for a while. As we've done so with the Sicilians, the Polish, and to a very small extent the English. I mean, they are taking settlements, just not very quickly. We do need to get our way, make our way back to England to finish them off. Problem is, I keep coming out here with only a fraction of my maximum force just because we don't have time to wait for them. In the amount of time it takes to wait for them, which would be about a week to get maximum force. The thing is, they're out there fighting the enemies at the same time as well, trying to protect their own territory from raiders. I bet you at some point during our fight against the Navarrese, somebody else will declare war on us. Probably not the Islamic factions. They tend to just mind their own business. It's the Christian ones that are the problem. I can't seem to jump up there. If you don't mind, let me through. Oh, fucking javelins. Okay, let me through. Don't mind me, motherfuckers. I'm just gonna go kill your archers. Fuck you and your damn beard. Okay, so far, we're doing well. We've got a good kill ratio. Fuck do you think you are? Fuck off! Fucking javelins! Jeez, well that wasn't good. Lost half my health. Jeez, my guys are getting absolutely slaughtered at the moment. Need to put a stop to that. Alright. If you don't mind, I need to break through here. I should have told my guys to stay put or something, because they just get in my way a lot of the time. Can't have these javelin men sitting around here causing me problems. Okay, well they're here. Let me see. Let me get up here. Oh, they're dealing with it. Let me get up on this tower here and I'll shoot them. And it's not the... Actually, this might actually work alright. Oh, get out of my way, fucking losers. So get down there and get into the fight. Might also help if I shoot these guys over here. Anyone without a shield needs to be shot before they get there. Shouldn't be that hard to hit. Got him. If they're not running with their shield up, fucking get him. Stop this goddamn javelin, man. Then we'll shield for you. So you can die. Got him? Good. Oh, I can't hit anyone from that distance. What are these? Any arrows here? Strelly. Well, whatever. I'm going to be hard-pressed to hit them from here. Let's have a look at how the battle's going. We're actually doing quite well. Got more kills than they do. Keep pushing forward. No reinforcements on the way yet. Problem is, we've only killed 150 of them. That's 350 left to go. Massive pain in the ass. Before they block me off. Alright, good. What are my guys up to? Good, I need to clear the way for them to come through here and infiltrate them. What's going on up here? They're all stuck. Well, that's good. Oh shit. Shield bashes. Now this is their reinforcement spot, so it's really not a safe place to be. At the same time, gotta kill as many of them as I can. They'll probably be showing up any second. The next wave of reinforcements. Seems like our guys have got them sandwiched there. That's great. I'll just stay right here. Let them pass. Oh, shit. Out of my way. Let them through the door, but they're gonna lose, I don't know, fifth of their men coming through. No, I gotta stay here. It's a good kill zone. Oh shit, they pushed through my guys. Whatever, at least I'm here. So looking at this, the battle's about even. We've lost about the same amount they have. Which it's not really great, but at least we're making some progress. Okay, their reinforcements should be showing up any second. There we go. Many of them through here to slow down their reinforcements. Oh no, you don't. You guys fucking die. You know what? I'm just gonna chase them. Oh jeez. No, I'm not actually, because they're javelin men. That's fucking can't deal with that shit. Okay, this isn't really working for me here. Okay, that's half of them dead. Let me think. I wonder if I can shoot these guys from here. These guys are always a pain whenever we come at them. Probably not going to last much longer. Jeez, if I stand there, I'm going to get killed. I'll have to come down here if I want to shoot them. God damn it. Fucking javelins. How the hell are they even able to come close to me from this range? With a bloody javelin. Roughly 1-to-1 kill ratio. Ah, shit, there we go. Knew that was gonna happen. Ah, damn it, look at that stupid spear. Delivered zero damage. That's a good way to describe the fucking spear. Use the shit to pick up a weapon from the ground. Still dishing out zero damage, man. What a weak. Also try and focus on taking back settlements that were recently taken, because obviously they won't have full garrison yet. From both the Teutonic Order and Navarre. I know what some people might be thinking, why don't I put a lord in there? To answer the question a number of times, because people will answer it multiple times, I'm sure. We'll ask it multiple times. We don't want to issue new lords on settlements all the time because it causes problems with other lords. Yes, it does increase garrison, but it also cost me a lot to keep these lords in line for settlements that are really most likely to be lost anyway, even if it does have 500 men protecting the settlement. Alright, only about 150 of them remain. Once again, I've got some dickhead with only a spear. And then, of course, the people that say, well, why not upgrade your units? Doesn't matter. Like I need to spend even more money on these useless shits. It's a fortune to upgrade units. I'd much rather spend my money diplomatically keeping my lords in line. I might be able to get in here. Come on, oh, there we go, got something. Just picked up the first thing I could find. Well, that went not too bad. Well, there. Well, even if I'm just doing damage to them, it's still better than nothing. I doubt any of my guys are one hit killers. How are we going now? Nearly at 5, so we've got 400 kills, so there's only 100 of them left. Oh shit, he's dead. And I'm stuck. That's right, just wait. They couldn't have too many more waves of reinforcements now. They had, what, 515 men in their tops? So we've lost about 400 men as well. And their archers are shooting us from here as well. So some more of their reinforcements are coming. I still think they've got maybe one more wave of reinforcements, but it wouldn't be much. Okay, good. Pushing forward. No, actually, I think this is their final loss. I don't think they're getting any more than this. Just adding up the numbers there. Definitely the final wave. Now we just need to go and defeat the 25 remaining missile units up here. I probably shouldn't be, like, charging at them if I'm thinking about my own self-preservation, but I'm thinking in regard to the battle. If they're shooting at me, that's fine. Gives them time to get here. Hang on, I've got another shield. I'll use that. Wow, someone was shooting at my back there. You can kill a couple of us, but you can't kill us all, motherfuckers. Don't use a spear. At least I managed to kill someone. Oh, hang on, I'm not out yet. Okay. I'm gonna go near here and try and shoot at them. Plus, there's a few javelins on the ground over here that I can pick up. Not yet, but... yeah, not until I've used up some of these. Oh, fuck, they saw me coming. Everywhere but where I want it to bloody land. There we go. Did some damage to them. Give me this fucking thing. No, that doesn't matter, the battle's over. I'll just let them deal with it from here. So if you look at how many men we lost a little bit under 500, so that's not too bad. And of course a lot of our soldiers are just wounded. Which doesn't really matter if they don't bloody heal. That's done. Take a few of these for myself. My renown's going down even further. Oh well, it happens. Gotta bolster our ranks for the next fight. I'm just glad we're no longer at war with the Latin Empire. I mean, they'll get their comeuppance, but we chose a bad time to decide to act on a provocation. Now, if I was to go and have a look to see on our faction screens, see who else has a provocation against us, let's have a look. Hopefully no one, because we don't have time to act on it. And I've got plenty of food, so I don't have to worry about that. So if we go notes, factions, us, let's have a look. Okay, Roman Empire recently suffered provocation by France, so it's risk of war. Oh my god, both ways. I can't declare war on France, and if they declare war on me, that's a disaster. Oh shit. Stupid diplomatic crap. There's almost no... There's half the factions we have some sort of problem with. Alright, so this area here, we're clear here. All of the real fighting is happening up here, and none of these territories really matter that much. Olmutz was recently taken by the Teutonic Order. I mean, whilst I do want to defeat the Navarrese, if they're up here, this land out here doesn't matter. What if we came over here, took Olmutz, and made our way over here to Britain and defeated them? Because we need to be defeating factions, and I think it would actually be quicker to defeat Britain than, or England, than the Navarrese. Hang on, what was this here? No, that's nothing. Morale always be low. Let him raid. That doesn't mean much. Okay, where is Zagad? It's here. How many forces do we have? Can we defeat them? Because if we defeat their armies, it depends on how much we've got. We'll be having to run by here anyway, but let's just see what they've got. Because if we can defeat their armies, we'll stop them for a while. Problem is, though, I don't know how easy it's going to be to defend Zagad. Come on, guys, get over here. And if our guys keep getting defeated, it's going to cost me money every time they lose. If they're not devoted to me, that is. Olmutz is quite a while away. Alright, so we're probably looking at a couple of thousand here. Just from here, and there's, of course, there's a lot more. There's not much we can do about that, I think. I don't know what Zagad is like. It could be a disaster to try and defend it. Oh my god. GG. Game over, basically. With France at our throat, we're in serious trouble. Goddamn, we need to get to Olmutz. There's just no stopping this now. It's a fucking rape train. I just can't be everywhere at once. Grindy, grindy, grindy shit. We have to go and defeat... We have to defeat factions. So England has to be defeated. Hopefully... The French are always at war with someone. So if I have a look here, go to notes. Factions. France. Who are they at war with? They're at war with us. They're at war with... No one else. Oh, god damn it. We're in serious trouble. Now, we're at war with just about every Catholic faction now. Or every Christian faction. We've got to get rid of get rid of England. If we get rid of England, that's someone we don't have to worry about anymore. And then we can... We'll already be in French territory. Maybe we go and defeat the French regions in England. Taken prisoner by France. Bastards. Alright, let's have a look how many people they've got here, because this was recently taken. Okay, we should be fine to take this. It won't take us too long. God damn it. Fucking siege tower, 24 hours. At least we've got a lot of lords here. Oh, jeez. I don't know what I can do about that. Here's the problem. I just don't know what to do. There's no diplomatic solution for any of this. The thing is, they'll cut us down to size to, like, I don't know, back to where we were right after we defeated, I don't know, someone. And then they've curbed our power. But then we've got to rebuild ourselves back up there. But at the same point, it's like, I don't know. Once we get rid of some of these smaller factions and allow, for example, France to grow a bit stronger, they won't feel so threatened by us. France is probably the mega power at the moment, next to me. But of course, having so many enemies is just a disaster. Hang on, what am I doing? I need to be shooting. There's only 250 of them, let's just deal with this. The problem is we can't just do what we did previously and just defend ourselves in all settlements, which is what I was able to do when he only had Italy, because... it's just a different situation now. I can't even get to all these settlements in time. I can't teleport across the map. Our lands are too vast. I can't count on my lords to take them down. This is why we have to get peace treaties, and we have to defeat certain factions. I mean, eventually these guys will burn out. Whoever's fighting us, and we'll get, you know, time of peace. We got 20 days of peace with the Imperium Romanae. We can get a lot done in that amount of time. Not that they were ever a massive threat. And a lot of the settlements we're losing don't really matter yet. But once they start taking our core Italian settlements, then we're in trouble. This is why France is really bad, because they're right on Italy's border. We may need to actually just go straight up and at them. Find a way to defeat the French. Take some of their territories. Right, need to get clear off their archers. This battle's not going to be too hard. Olmos is not well defended, because they only recently took it. The defense is a little bit soft. We can't stay up here fighting the Teutonic Order. It's just not going to work. The biggest problem is my armies can't face off against them. We're too weak, because we've been constantly fighting. The French, they really attacked us at the worst possible time. Get rid of Sicily, only to have to deal with the French. No mood for any bullshit now, guys. Just roll over and fucking die. Alright, that's them dealt with. This battle's going well. Problem is it cost us 24 hours to build a siege tower. Oh, cool, just bouncing on their heads. I didn't take any fall damage. Not that it particularly matters. Who's this here? Yeah, if we get rid of the English, that'll certainly help. And then we'll conquer the English regions... the French territory in England. That makes sense. Try and cut the French right down to size. I mean, the thing is, when we went and conquered all the English settlements, I mean, we did it. We conquered all of their settlements in England, but they managed to take some back before we finished. Because we couldn't engage them head on, but I can conquer settlements faster than, I don't know, maybe three or four at us at once. But not, what is it now, five or six? Because there's Novgorod, they're not really doing much. The Navarrese of the Teutonic Order, they're the ones really giving us a hard time. Sicily can't do shit now, they're pretty much gone. We need some peace treaties. I mean, we've been through dark times before when we were much weaker than this. So we'll get through it, it's gonna be a massive struggle and a grind before we get to a moment where we can start steamrolling factions again. I kind of wish I had hired more lords, but then again, I did bankrupt myself getting as many as I could. There's no point hiring new lords, it's just going to cause the other ones you've got to defect. That's great. Absolutely slaughtering these guys. More of these bloody provocations keep happening. Like, for example, the Ilkhanate joined back at war with this. That's going to be a problem. Then again, they never actually took any settlements. Here we go. Seems like we're done. take some of this. All of that. I still don't feel like I need to take this stuff just yet, even though the situation is bad. I mean, France hasn't besieged anything just yet. They're probably just collecting their forces. And even though they're going to have the biggest army, I can still conquer faster than them. So, let me just have a look at how much food we've got left. Still got plenty. So, we'll just let that be. Maybe I'll just get a few of the foods that we don't have. I kind of wish when the food went rotten, it would just disappear from my inventory. I didn't have to keep tossing it out. Okay, so Olmutz is retaken. They just took Zagged. Zagged, I don't think anyone owned Zagged, because they took that very quickly. We could come up here to Poznan. Or we can make our way over here. So if we have a look at England, we've got 1, 2, 3 settlements that they've retaken. And of course, there's London and all this other shit over here that we need to take against the French. My biggest concern is if they come into my territory here, maybe we should attack them head on here and really protect our core territories here and just fight the French head on. Because if we fight them in this area here, I can draw reinforcements from here. I think that's what I should do. I can't, if I lose Milan or Genova, I lose a lot of money. I can't allow that to happen. But I can defend those settlements because I know that there's lots of troops there. Anyway, that's the end of this episode. So like and subscribe. Part 86 is next. And don't forget to visit me on Facebook. See you next time, fuckers.